So it actually ended up being like a 2-day type thing. So you came one day, emergency call at night, then found out what the issue was and I had to come back the next day. So kind of like a 2-step.
Man, I'm listening to this and I'm like, man, so.
I mean, it turned out to be a dirty evaporator coil, but that's not something we clean in the middle of the night. I mean, I was checking the pressures because everything else seemed to be working perfectly. So here we go on this down the troubleshooting rabbit hole. As always, we're going to see, we're going to find out what's going on. And this here brings us to the next day. Let's get it. And even though I checked the pressures the previous night, I'm still going to check them on this day because pressures vary due to temperature, so we might get a different reading and it might tip me off to something else that's going on with this system. Yeah, I think around this time my gauges had started malfunctioning. I was getting different readings I ain't like. I went ahead and bought some new ones. So after we checked the refrigerant levels, I went and checked the static pressure and I noticed we need the coil cleaning. The one thing I feel like I could have did different or should have did different was I should have did a pull and clean instead of a clean in place, because of course you always get better results with a pull and clean. So looking back at it, I kind of went away from doing clean in place. This is nowhere near as effective as a pull and clean, and to be honest, it's kind of the lazy way. It's kind of the easy way out. And then the oddest thing about it is, even though it's the lazy way, the easy way out, even though I'm saying that, it's actually more work than just doing a pull and clean.
Cooking. I'm ready to eat too.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm doing this. I'm also making sure I'm not bending the fins. But when you bend the fins, you're doing the same thing. You're causing the airflow restriction. So it sounds like I'm raking it, but really, if you're up close and personal like I am right now, I'm not bending the fins. It's all good. Yeah, but as I'm looking and knowing what I know now, a pulling clean is just far more effective. You see, to me, a clean in place is more like you're cleaning the face of it, but you're not cleaning the opposite side. A pulling clean, I would have got the hose, and I would have known that all those fins and coils were free. I would have been able to put water through the backside, the inside, and I would be able to watch water go through it. Right now, it's like you're just cleaning the face of a thing, and you're not entirely going into it being as intrusive as you should be, as you would have been with a pulling clean. Yeah, so we're done for now. Because next time I came back to this unit, I ended up having to do a pull and clean anyway. It just worked out better, more efficient, lasts longer. Plus, to be honest, it's what we should have done the first time.